Thank you for watching, and in this chapter, which is called sketch tool, we are going to cover all sketch tools in very detail. And in this video, we are going to cover the line, center line and midpoint line. So you can go in any of the front plane or top plane or right plane. So you can go into the any plane and then you can click. Suppose I want to go into the front plane, and then you can see, like, if you are gonna click any plane and then you can just hold your mouse there for a moment, so you can see there is an option, and this is a small pop-up. So what you can do is you can just click the sketch and then you can go and then you can start sketching. Or there is another option, like if you want to go, if you want to sketch, suppose you want to sketch top plane or right plane, whatever the plane, the first option is, if you are not gonna move your cursor, you can see sketch plane here, sketch option here. Otherwise, what you can do is you can go here into the tabs and you can see here into the ribbon section, there is an option for sketch. So you can go into the sketch from here as well. And then as we are gonna cover the line, so I'm gonna go into the line command, line, center line or midpoint line. So let's start with the line. So if you want to make line, so what you can do is you can just click somewhere, you are already into the line command. And then if you are gonna click somewhere, so it would be a point there, you can add another point here, or you can add another point somewhere here. But there is another point which you need to notice, like if you are pointing your line here, as you can see after that there are different yellow lines here. So if you want to have a parallel line to this direction, you can follow this yellow line, or if you want to have next line part into the perpendicular of this previous line, so what you can do is you can just go and then you can have a perpendicular line. Or if you want to make a circle, so what you can do is you can just rotate your cursor around this point, and then what you can do is you can draw a circle or whatever you want. Or if you want to go out of the command, so what you can do is you can just press escape on your keyboard. So in this way, I would be out of the command. Suppose if you want to draw different kind of lines or different kind of segments, so what you can do is you can again go back into the line and then you can draw your lines. So one option is, like, you can just click, then in this way your command will be still on, and if you want to go out of the command, you need to press escape on your keyboard. Or if you want to click somewhere and you don't want to have the command turn on, so what you can do is, like, again you can go into the line and then you don't need to click it, you just need to point and hold the mouse. Like, I started my line from here, I hold my left key on my mouse, and then wherever I'm gonna drag, so I just need to remove the hold cursor of my mouse, and then the command is not gonna be on anymore. So in that way I can have just one segment of the line. And one more thing, like, if you don't like any design of these segments, so what you can do is you can add different kind of relations. Suppose I want to have a relation between this segment and this segment, so I'm gonna select this segment and then I'm gonna hold the control key on my keyboard and then I'm gonna select this segment. So in that way you can see there is an option, there is a pop-up, like you can add different kind of relation, you can make them horizontal, perpendicular or collinear, or you can have a perpendicular relation, you can make them parallel, equal, or you can fix them at some point. These are all options are here. So into the feature manager as well, suppose if I want to have these two segments perpendicular to each other, so I'm going to select perpendicular, and in this way these two segments are perpendicular, as you can see there is a 90 angle between them. Or if I want to have a relation between these two segments, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select this segment and I'm gonna hold the control key on my keyboard, and then I'm gonna select this segment as well. And then you can see here all the options, or you can go into the feature manager and then you can have these options as well. So right now you can see this segment is smaller and this is bigger. So if I want to make them equal, so what I can do is I can just press equal, so both have an equal length, as you can see. So in that way I can have a different kind of I can add different kind of relations, or I can fix them, or I can move them as whatever I want. So this is about the line. So let's go into the center lines. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would found a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you. So center line or the construction lines, both are the same. So if suppose I have this line, so if I want to convert this line into a construction line, so what I can do is I can just select this segment or this line, and then I'm gonna go into the feature manager. As you can see here, into the options, like I can just select for construction, and then I'm going to click the green check mark. So in this way, I can just convert this line into a construction line. Or another option is I can go into the line and I can draw a center line here. So center line and construction line both are similar. Maybe like you can see a bit difference into their design, but both works pretty similar. Like you can use them as a rotational axis, or if you want to skip them from any sketch and you don't want to have extrude them, or you don't want to have any kind of action on them, so you can just, what you can do is you can convert those lines or those segment into the construction geometry. So in that way they are not gonna work anymore. Okay, or you can just, what you can do is like you can just control them to make some kind of dimensions, or if you want to have less dimension. So let's take an example. I can show you how we can use construction lines or center lines, and then we can control our sketch. I'm gonna go back again into the front plane. I'm gonna go back into the front plane and go into the sketch. So what I can do is like, if I'm gonna start a line from here to here and then here, and then I'm gonna complete it here, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark, and then let's go again into the line, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna draw a center line from this point till this point, and then I want to have another center line from this point till this point, and then my center line is still on, so I can press escape on my keyboard, then I would be out of this command. And what I can do is like I can just select this line, I can hold the control key on my keyboard, and then I can select another line. So in that way, all the options for the relations could be in appear in front of the screen. So I want to have a perpendicular relation between these two center lines. So, and then you can see these two center lines are perpendicular to each other. So I'm going to click the green check mark. Okay, after that, what I want to do is I was thinking to move them somewhere else, because I want to bring this center onto the origin. So I want to make it more difficult. It is really easy, but I already made a relation which is perpendicular relation between these two center lines. So what the next thing what I want to do is I want to add a point. So I am just gonna zoom a bit, and then I'm gonna go here into the ribbon section, and as you can see, there is an option for the point. So I'm gonna click the point, and then I can just hover my cursor onto this line, and you can see there is a midpoint for this line. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna hover my cursor on this line, and then I would found my center point here. So I'm gonna draw a point on this point, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. And after that, in the next step, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select this point, and then I'm gonna hold the control key on my keyboard, and then I'm gonna select this line. By mistake, I'm just adding another point there. So I'm gonna go and control Z. So in that way, I just deleted that point. And now what I'm gonna do again is like, I'm gonna select this point, and then I'm gonna hold the control key, and I'm gonna select this line. So in that way, like I can add a relation. So what I want to do is I want to have a midpoint between these two lines. So that's why this point moved from here to midpoint, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. Okay, so I have a midpoint for them. So this is my midpoint. So what I can do is now I want to bring this point to the origin. So what I can do is I can just zoom a bit, and then I can select my point, then I can hold the control key on my keyboard, and then I can come into the origin, and then I can select the center of the origin. And then you can see there is option for the midpoints for the, I can made a relation between these two points. What I want to do is I want to coincident between these two points. So in that way, my point is just gonna fly from that point till here. So because they both are coincident now. So this is my triangle. I want to have a normal view. So let's go from that view till here. And now you can see what I can do is, because there is a relation, I can control my rectangle, you can say this way, or if I want to control into the vertical side, I can control them, or if I want to control it from bigger to smaller, because we already added relation. So That's why we can control this whole shape. Or so in this way, like you don't need to explain or put dimensions again and again. So in that way, like I don't need to give dimensions. So if you want to give dimensions, what you can do is you can just give some dimensions, only these two lines, and you don't need to give dimensions to all the segments. Look, so I just need to give only two dimensions, and that in this way I can control the whole shape. So look at that, like how the center line or construction line is really powerful, and we can control our sketches. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.